Hey, Rockers, Andrew here from Fire Rocker Studios, and today we are back in Minecraft 1.8, and as you guys can see behind me, I've got some cool little contraption stuff, because today we're gonna be doing a little tricks, tips, and secrets like episode for the 1.8 update, because today's a special day. The very first pre-release for 1.8 was released today, which means the 1.8 update will be coming out very, very soon officially. Now, it could be out by the time you guys are watching this, so if you're watching in the future, then this will still help you, because this is stuff that is currently in 1.8. So, I'm going to be showing you guys a couple of neat little tricks that have to do with the brand new armor stance, which were actually added very recently, as well as a couple of little neat little thingies for sprinting and going by a little bit faster in the world. But, let me go ahead and go into first-person point of view. Also, guys, I want to challenge you. Let's see if we can get to 500 likes on this. Let me know if you guys actually enjoy this, and then I will actually, if this gets 500 likes, I will buy myself do a whole, or not, what that is, that doesn't make any sense, but I will myself be releasing another episode, at least one new episode every single week, finding new tricks to basically help you guys do awesomeness in the new update. But yeah, also real quick, I do want to say that today is, if you're watching this, of course, this is the release of this video, is, what's it called, oh yeah, a Thursday, so I'm gonna be live streaming today, and if you guys want to follow me, it is in the description below, it is twitch.tv/firerockerstudios, but let's get on to what we are gonna be showing you. So here's the armor stand. You guys probably already seen it. If you've seen my videos, you can put armor on it, blah blah blah. Okay, so cool stuff about this is it kind of works somewhat like an anvil, where it will fall if you have things on it. Now, you can also kind of slide it around on the side. So for example, let me build a little example contraption right over here so you guys can see it in its works. And let me go put that down. Let me actually get a water bucket. So this is just so you guys know every little bit about the shingy. And I will put that right over there. So if I am to put a water bucket here, it will actually push said armor stand to the edge, and that is actually just a pretty neat little feature that, you know, you could do with the little armor stands. And also, you can glitch it sometimes. For example, right now it is stuck in the dirt, but yeah, the armor stands are pretty neat, and there is a bunch of stuff that you could do with them. Now, on to the next awesomeness, and what I'm going to be showing you guys today is you can also bump them. Now, let me first break this and show you guys. Now, with the sign blocks, which is another 1.8 feature, you can do this stuff and kind of pick stuff up, and it's actually incredibly trippy. So, for example, let me go ahead and get that. If I was to put a block right there, I wouldn't be able to move forward because it's kind of stuck to that, but if I was to remove it, then it'd be able to suck it and then kind of do that. So, it's a little bit weird, but yeah, a bunch of stuff to it. So, for example, if I do that, it kind of picks that up. So, just wanted to show you that. Now, for if you go ahead and try this and you have something underneath there and it won't work, that's exactly why. So, if you make this yourself and it's not working, it's because you have this block here. So, it'll work like that, but you're gonna have to reset it. Unless if you figure out a way of doing it otherwise. So, what do you basically do? Put an anvil there, or not an anvil, you put the armor stand right over there. And this is just to really MacGyver a cool little trick. I just thought this was neat. You could put a pressure plate over here, and any source, you could have TNT there, whatever. Hit this, and then bam! It literally will slide it, and it will, I don't know, it's just pretty neat. That's literally it. There's nothing too special about it. I just thought it was pretty cool that you could do that. So, again, you put the block right over there, put the little armor stand there, and bam, it will slide it, and it's just pretty cool. This works great if you're you can make just pretty neat contraptions with this. So I will do an example right now. Let me get another sticky piston, put that here, and I'll put the slime block right there. Let's get you right over here, brother, and I will move this over here, and let's, this is gonna be probably, we'll do a little bit of destruction. Let's make this fun. Let's get some TNT, and I shall put you right over here, and let's make this pretty big. I'll put TNT all over that little edge, and we'll do a little quickie test, making sure everything is good for this. Okie dokie, that's all good. I will put you over there. Put the armor stand over there. Put this other armor stand right. Let me suck this one back in. Break you, pop you, hit you. And 3, 2, 1, fire! There you go. That actually worked surprisingly well. And that is, my friends, a pretty neat little trick for basically, if you don't want to have a bunch of redstone, you can now do stuff with just using this. So yeah, you don't need redstone. Of course, you could also use tripwire and a bunch of other things, but I thought that was pretty neat, and it'll look really cool. You can have like a little sliding thing that literally goes boop boop boop, 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 and it could go super far, and it's just pretty cool to look at. So, neat little trick for building stuff. And the other trick, which I don't know if this is 100% brand new, but in general, people are wondering if you could fly faster. So, sprinting in midair, I don't think it's a normal thing. So, maybe if you hit shift, or if you're shifting... Wait, let me see this. Okay, so if you're... Yeah, no, it doesn't work. So, how do you run faster while you're in creative mode? Sprint and then jump, and then you can pretty much sprint fly. I don't know if this is a brand new feature, but I was told this in the comment section down below, and I also wanted to go ahead for people that don't know already. You could do slash game mode space 3, and you will be in a spectator mode. And with this, if you use your scroll wheel, you can actually go incredibly fast, and you can go through things. So, a lot of my viewers that have been keeping up to me with the 1.8 stuff obviously already know this, but this video is meant for everybody. So, if you do not already know, you can fly up and down super fast, go underneath the world and explore everything. And of course, if you scroll back down, you will actually go very slow to the point where you actually will stay still, which is also pretty neat. And then if I release it a bit, I can actually fly pretty freaking slow. And then go back to normal, and then back to super speed. And then, I just have to do slash game mode 1, and I am back. And game mode 2 is our adventure mode, and game mode 0 is normal survival. But yeah guys, that is Minecraft 1.8 tips, tricks, and secrets. So a couple little tricks, couple little secrets, and just a couple of awesomeness for you guys that may not know everything about the 1.8 update. If you guys want to see more of these episodes, please leave a like, show your support, make sure to check out my stream. Let me know in the comment section down below any tricks that you know and you would like me to show off in another episode. And yeah, that's about it for this, and here is the outro. Hey, did you enjoy this video? I really hope you did, and if you want to stay up to date with all the videos that I post, because I post literally every single day on all three of my channels, you better follow me. It is at FRZWorld. That is my Twitter and my Instagram. It's right here on the top right of this little screen. And of course, I have my vlogging channel, which is FRZWorld, where I post daily videos, as well as Andrew vs. Games, where I post game videos like, you know, GTA and Goat Simulator and Battlefield and all those thingies. And right below that is Firerocker Studios, which is my main channel where I post 2 to 3 videos a day, every single day. That's also the same as my Twitch, which is twitch.tv/Firerocker Studios. I actually took the time to annotate this for you, so hurry up and click those links. Now, if you're on a mobile device and you don't have annotations turned on, if you go to the description of this video, you will find all the links to all my three channels, plus my Twitter and my Instagram and my Twitch, so you have no reason to not follow them or subscribe to them. So you better do that now. And also, if you haven't already, give this video a like. Of course, only if you want to. I wouldn't want to force you to do anything. But you better do that because, you know, it shows that you're awesome. And subscribe to all of my channels. Because if you haven't, then you won't be getting updates. Like, come on, you gotta subscribe and follow me on Twitch, man. Because I stream on there at least 3 to 4 times a week. I try. I mean, my schedule's up there. So, yeah, pretty much, if you want to stay up to date with everything that I do, you better follow me on Twitter, at FRZWorld, because I tweet all the time, literally, all the time. So, follow me there, guys, and, yeah, you actually watched to this point. Like, the video's over. You can go now. Go watch my other videos. Like, literally, on the top left, if you're on the computer, like, and have annotations on, I put the back and the next video, so go watch other videos. You know, you can do that now. You can subscribe, too, if you haven't already, but, like, if you haven't already, like, what are you waiting for? Like, subscribe. Come on. Do it. Did you do it? Good. Good. Now, go watch another video. Bye. I'm gonna roll the music now, because this is just getting weird.